Hello guys, today we will be discussing part C questions of December 2017 NET paper. So what I have planned that I will upload daily 5 questions from part C. So today I am uploading first 5 questions of part C. So this is the first question from part C from organic. So what they have given, cyclohexanone, this diethyl propyne, then acetic acid. Okay, so option is second option, but how it will be second option that we will discuss. I have not discussed here, I have not drawn here options, but I have drawn mechanism. Okay, so see now, so what is the role of cyclohexanone? Like you know that in many Michael addition reaction, this enone having beta position is electrophilic and alpha position is nucleophilic, right? due to minus R effect. Okay, and when you look at this moiety, so this nitrogen have lone pair, it will donate electron here, then it, so which means here beta, this alpha and this beta position is nucleophilic. Okay, in propyne case beta position is nucleophilic and in enone case beta position is electrophilic, right? Now what happened, this will donate electron here, this will attack here. Then see now, this is actually sp hybridized, but I have drawn this for convenience. Now what happened, once this will get this nitrogen will get protonated after donation of electron, so this will again shift here, and we know that alpha position is nucleophilic in enone case and here alpha position is electrophilic. So now this will attack at this position. Okay, and we are getting 4-membered cyclobutene ring derivative. So now when you look at this molecule carefully, it is like enamine. What is enamine? Enamine is alpha beta unsaturated amine, is our enamine. Okay, now what they have given in question, acetic acid. Okay, acetic acid means we also have water and we also have H plus ion, we also have acetate ion. Okay, so now I have done first protonation. So protonation occur at this is a nucleophile pi bond, this is electrophile, this will protonate at this position. Now this will carry positive charge. To balance this, then water molecule will attack. We can also show this mechanism by acetate attack, but for simplicity I have taken here water as a nucleophile. So water will attack here, then you will get this protonated water, then this H plus will get removed to balance that. Now this is OH and diethylamine is there at this position, then again protonation will, now in order to make it good leaving group, see now this is the strong base and diethylamine, and we know that strong bases are not a good leaving group. So in order to make it a good leaving group, we need to protonate it. It will get protonated here, and now what happened, this will push electron here, like you see in above case, like I have shown here, this has this oxygen will have to push here, and this will now remove as a good leaving group. So NH82S will get removed. Now again this is getting protonated. Okay, now I have continued this mechanism here. Now again deprotonation will take place and this ketone will form. Then again water will attack at this position, then diol will form, and we know that diol is very unstable and it open up to give acid. So how it will be giving acid, see now I am spreading, I am transferring electron here at this position, and this will get open at this alpha position. And we know that negative charge is stabilized at alpha position by resonance. Yes, as I discussed earlier, starting only. So now, finally what happened? This will get protonated here, and you will end up with getting beta substitution, like in Michael addition, but this is a modified version of Michael addition. Via thermal 2 plus 2 addition, it will form at this position. Okay, so when you look at this mechanism, it's very simple, but when you apply this concept like minus R, plus R effect, as well as this concept of this diol opening, then it's very easy because you are depend on fundamental of organic. So next question which is there is also very easy, and again it's very conceptual. See now, what they have asked, they have given everything, starting material, reactant, analog product. So they have asked this sequence of reactions, Michael addition, aldol, keto, you know, this is the right answer, and how it is right, that I will discuss now. Now see, KOH is there, this is our most acidic proton is here only. So what happened, this will get removed, and then this will attack here. So this is our simple Michael addition, and this is Michael adduct. We can say addition product of Michael is known as Michael adduct. Okay, addition product means adduct. So first step is Michael adduct, Michael addition. Second is intramolecular aldol condensation. Proton will get removed from here and it will attack here, and you will get aldol or ketol. You can also say ketol. Ketol is more appropriate to say this, but in common term, we are always using aldol condensation. Now, by E1CP mechanism, this proton will get removed here and double bond will come here, as in standard aldol direction we are doing. So see, now one double bond came here, and in common, when we are using Michael addition and in intermolecular aldol condensation, commonly we are referring as a Robinson adulation, but they have not asked here. That is also right answer, Robinson adulation. So now what happened? Scene elimination will take place whenever selenoxide or sulfoxide is there and heating condition, this will get removed. Scene elimination, that means if it is above the plane, it will also remove this hydrogen from above the plane. If it is below, it will always remove from below. The same plane, it will remove hydrogen. So it also give then sulfoxide is reduced to our sulfide kind of things. So now here also double bond came. Okay, now what we do, finally we will tautomerize this ketone, and we know equilibrium will shift more toward this, in order to, because this is aromatic, so it is more stable. This enol form is more stable than this keto form. So final answer is our this, which they have given in option, and reaction is Michael addition, intramolecular aldol condensation, and then scene elimination, then tautomerism. Okay. Now this 83rd question, what they have asked, they have given this starting material, and they have also given product with rhodium catalyzed reaction, and we know that rhodium catalyzed and copper catalyzed are commonly used in carbon reaction. So this is right answer is 2,3 sigma tropic. How it is right, that I will discuss, and why it is right I will discuss. So so what I have done, this is a carbene, okay, not carbene, it will act like a carbene when you draw it, when you draw the resonance form of this carbon and N2, this carbon also have one carbene like structure. So oxygen will attack at this position, okay. Now what happened, now nitrogen is getting removed here, okay. Nitrogen is getting removed, and when nitrogen is getting removed here, we also have this carbene. See these two electrons, we also have this carbene. So this carbene, what happened, this carbene will attack, this rhodium will attack at this position, and it is getting stabilized. Okay, now we know that addition to metal, everywhere there is a negative charge is there. What I mean, like in Grignard region, if you take addition to magnesium, there is a negative charge, carbon ion is there. Similarly, this is a temporary stabilization of this negative charge by rhodium. Okay. Now, what happened? This negative charge will attack at this position. Okay. And this double bond will migrate at this position. And this oxygen having positive charge, it is stabilized now by this bonding pair of electron. Okay. So when you number it, this electron, so this is 1, this is 2, okay, and allylic position we are numbering 1, 2, 3, so this is basically 2, 3 sigma tropic reaction, 2, 3 sigma tropic, rhodium acid will go away and we will get this product, okay. So I will discuss some more concept here, like why it is not 1, 2 shift rearrangement. 1, 2 shift, for 1, 2 shift rearrangement condition, same you can catalyze this reaction by rhodium acetate, you will get here this carbon type compound stabilized by this rhodium acetate. Then this will attack at this position, this oxygen nucleophile, so you will get this product. Then here you can see this carbon is there, rhodium attached, this carbon attached to rhodium, and this is nucleophilic. Then it will pull this electron towards itself, and this is getting stabilized here like this. So this is actually 1-2 shift rearrangement. This also has in 2014 or 15 CSIR. And now what is CH insertion? So whatever we have discussed here now, this question, in common it is called as CH insertion. But to be specific, CH insertion is like you have some hydrocarbon and you have some carbene catalyzed by rhodium, and this R is inserted at this position. This is in common we can say CH insertion. Okay. So right answer is our 2,3 sigma tropic rearrangement. And this is the source of anion. Now This is where you ask, this question is asked from Clayton also, only from retrosynthesis. So what they have asked, they have given starting material product, and this is a two step reaction they have given, and they have mentioned the reagent, which reagent we can use from this. So what is the exact answer for this question? First, this is anthranilic acid. Anthranilic acid first react with our 4-chloropyridine by SNAR mechanism or addition elimination type mechanism or halogen replacement, any name we can give to this reaction. So in that case, what happened? We have this 4-chloropyridine. Okay, this nitrogen will attack at this position, and this first, see now, first addition will take place. Then by when you look at this mechanism, this negative, this when this attack is taking place, this negative charge stabilizes at this nitrogen position. Okay, then again it will go back to, and this chlorine will eliminate. So we are saying addition elimination type of mechanism. So first step, first product you will get by addition elimination mechanism. Then when you use SOCl2, we know that what is the use of SOCl2 in organic chemistry, in order to chlorinate OH group or acid group. So here it will activate this acid group to acid chloride. Okay, now we know that when acid chloride is there and amine is there, coupling reaction will take place and amide bond will form. So see here, this amide bond is getting forming by loss of HCl. HCl will get lost and amide will get formed. So now reason, what is the reason why I have not used thionyl chloride initially? If I use thionyl chloride first, then what happened? Acid is getting converted to acid chloride, but along with it, what happened? NH2 is also converted into its salt. Now this is salt is, now once this salt is formed, then SNA reaction or halogen replacement not take place. Okay, because that lone pair of nitrogen is get utilized by forming acid salt. Okay, now this reaction, first time they have asked this reaction, but when you look at this reagent, it is like a Gilman reagent. Gilman reagent, we are knowing that R2CuLi or Ar2CuLi, okay, but most commonly R2Cu, aliphatic only Gilman is there. So right answer is, this is the right option. Okay, fourth option. So what is the logic we have to use first? Whenever we see epoxide, so epoxide under SN1 condition, that means in acidic condition, it will always give stable carbocation, and epoxide under SN2 condition give less stable carbocation or attack of nucleophile from less hindered side of epoxide, or attack from nucleophile from less hindered side. Okay, so two logic we always remember, these two logic on epoxide. Epoxide under acidic condition gives stable carbocation and follow SN1 mechanism, and epoxide under basic condition or nucleophilic condition always give or under SN2 condition, it always give a nucleophile attack from less hindered side of epoxide. Okay, so this is the reagent they have given, and this reagent is like a Gilman reagent, and see, it can attack from two sides. According to option, what they have given this vinyl position attack and this thiophen position attack. And we know that one among these two, one which is more nucleophilic, that will attack first. So we know that this, by that concept, if you apply, this thiophen is a less nucleophilic compared to vinyl position. That logic also we can apply, as well as other logic what we can apply. This copper and this thiophen bond is strong. It is more stable. Lesser the bond strength, more is the bond order. Okay, so that logic also we can apply. We can say that here vinyl is the attacking species, vinyl anion, basically, not vinyl anion, CH2- like this, vinyl anion. So basically SN2 pathway, there is no condition of acid condition is not there in our reaction condition. See now, look at here, there is no acidic condition here. This we have, but this is for quenching purpose, not for reacting purpose. This is the basic condition or nucleophilic condition, we can say. And lithium plus cannot open the epoxide. Always remember, lithium plus cannot open the epoxide. Okay, now see now. So what we have concluded from this reaction condition, that this is nucleophilic reagent. Okay, and we know that from basic that nucleophile always attack from less hindered side of epoxide. So by that logic, I have drawn here. acidic condition under SN1 will give you stable carbocation like this by four hyperconjugation structure. Here you will get only one hyperconjugation structure. So this is SN2 pathway, this is SN1 pathway. So what our starting material have? We have vinyl as a nucleophile. Okay, and this is follow, and this will follow SN2 pathway. So vinyl will attack from less hindered side. This is the less hindered side of this epoxide, and this epoxide will open from open mean this way. Okay, so always remember this, in SN2 condition we are getting attack of nucleophile from less hindered side. So this will get open in this way. So vinyl will attack at this position. Okay, so right option is about this fourth one. Okay, today I will discuss this five questions, or discuss this five question only. If you have any doubt, then post in the comment, as well as you can subscribe our channel for future videos. Thank you.